The World Health Organization once again sounding the alarm over the humanitarian crisis in Gaza. This as it reports Gaza's Kamal Adwan Hospital is not functioning anymore. Israeli forces reportedly used a bulldozer to smash through the hospital site. Israel claims the hospital is being used by Hamas fighters. Hamas has denied this.
We cannot afford to lose any hospitals. What we need to do, we, the health system, WHO, to assist and with partners, Shifa Hospital, because that's just, the reality is there are still thousands of people in the north. There's all kinds of estimates between 2 and even 600,000 people. And there need to be a number of health facilities functional. And Al-Shifa is, of course, should be the main one of the main one and currently minimum functional.
Israel signals a gradual transition in its war in Gaza. Israel's defense minister says civilians would likely be able to first return to Gaza's north. But no timeline was given in Israel's next phase of operations in Gaza.
We will continue to operate in different levels of intensity according to the situation in the region. And I can tell you that soon we will be able to distinguish between different areas in Gaza. In every area where we achieve our mission, we will be able to transition gradually to the next phase and start working on bringing back local population. That means that it can be achieved maybe sooner in the north rather than in the south. Second, Israel will not control Gaza in any civilian way. We will conduct any needed operation and military effort in order to secure our future. And we are building the routes for non-hostile partners in the other side.
The signal from Israel came during U.S. Defense Chief Lloyd Austin's visit. Austin held talks with Israeli officials about a lower intensity combat and ways to reduce harm on civilians.
This is Israel's operation, and I'm not here to dictate timelines or terms. Our support to Israel's right to defend itself is ironclad, as you've heard me say a number of times, and that's not going to change. It's critical, as I said earlier, that Hamas not be able to threaten Israel from Gaza or even threaten Gaza anymore. You know, that's an interest that we all share.
Israel is facing international pressure for a ceasefire following the deaths of more than 19,000 Palestinians as a result of its massive bombardment of Gaza. One of the Filipino hostages freed by Hamas, now back home. Jimmy Pacheco was released on November 24th after being taken by Hamas rebels when they attacked Israel on October 7. Despite this harrowing experience, Pacheco plans to return to Israel for work.
October 7, 6:30 in the morning, may narinig na kaming nag-alert ng Israel sa kibbutz namin na may darating na rockets, nagsirena na po. Bandang alas 7:30, mga ganon, sumilip ako sa bintana, may nakapasok ng terorista sa labas ng kibbutz namin sa fence. Babalik po. Kahit sinasabi nilang may lifetime pension po, ayaw ko pong umasa doon kasi mas maganda pa rin na sapayan ko po yun.
The Philippine and Israeli governments, meanwhile, vowed to provide assistance to Pacheco and his family.
There'll be a monthly income for the family, and then, of course, for special needs such as education, healthcare, etc.
Sinimulan na natin na iproseso ang scholarships ng mga bata. And specifically, minention ni Clarice na gusto niya magkaroon ng negosyo. Nag-agree naman si Jimmy na ang gusto niyo pwesto sa palengke.
The Vatican approves Roman Catholic priests to bless same-sex couples. The landmark ruling approved by Pope Francis states the blessings may be carried out as long as they are not part of regular church rituals or liturgies. Priests also have the freedom to decide on a case-by-case basis. The Vatican adds the blessings should not be confused with the sacrament of marriage. Still, many are welcoming the ruling, calling it a big step towards inclusivity in the Catholic Church.
I think it's wonderful. I mean, I never thought in my lifetime that I could marry my wife of 43 years. I never thought. And to have, she's an ex-nun, so it's got to be very, very meaningful to her on a whole other level than it is for me as a non-Catholic. But as a human being, this is wonderful. This is wonderful.
Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our Bureau Chief, TJ Manotok.
Good morning from Los Angeles. Here are the top stories making the headlines in the North American region. We begin with wicked weather across the eastern United States on Monday as heavy rain, flash floods, and snow were left in the wake of a coastal storm. Trees were falling and rivers were rising in Massachusetts, Pennsylvania, and New Hampshire. The National Weather Service said the storm will move northward into eastern Canada by Monday evening. Heavy rain is expected for the northern mid-Atlantic coast, northward to New England, and showers and thunderstorms over the northern mid-Atlantic coast and southern New England coast. Meanwhile, a heavy storm hit Florida this weekend, causing rainfall and gusty winds around the coastal area. Footage from Hollywood, Florida showed choppy waves, palm trees shaking in the wind, and flooded parking lots. 17 million people in Jacksonville, Orlando, and Tampa are under a threat of severe weather, as local media have reported. Florida Governor Ron DeSantis instructed the Florida Division of Emergency Management to monitor the low-pressure system heading towards southwest Florida and activated the Florida State Guard to prepare to respond to impact. In other news, NFL star Cameron Bynum is getting into the holiday spirit, Pinoy style. The Minnesota Vikings defensive back celebrated a Philippine fiesta with the Bynum Faith Foundation in Minnesota. He showed off his fancy footwork with a tinikling routine at the event to raise funds for his foundation's Philippine outreach. He's also been bringing his advocacy to the field through the NFL's My Cause, My Cleats program. NFL players have been decorating their cleats to raise awareness of issues and causes.
My cause, my cleats, Bynum Faith Foundation goes towards everything my family and I are doing in the Philippines. It's about to be a movie. Let's get it, baby.
This past weekend, his foundation teamed up with 49er star Drake Jackson for a Christmas shopping spree in their hometown of Corona, California. Bynum could not personally attend as he was playing against the Cincinnati Bengals and met with Philam Bengals rookie Andre Yosivas. And finally, hundreds of Filipino Christmas lanterns, or paroles, representing various parishes, were paraded inside the Cathedral of Our Lady of Angels in Los Angeles to mark the start of the traditional midnight masses, or Simbang Gabi.
Ang simbolo ng parol sa akin is very special. Ours is a star kasi yun yung liwanag na binibigay sa atin ni Jesus.
This is the kickoff and it's a big event participated by as many as 150 parishes in the five regions of the Archdiocese. There will be about 150 paroles, and they can be as far as Santa Barbara region in Lompoc, and it can be as near as the Cathedral Parish of Our Lady of the Angels.
They were colorful, traditional, yet modern. A Bahay Kubo, and some were fashioned from colors and symbols of the Philippine flag. But true to the Filipinos' festive nature, the outfits and gowns of the participants were also on parade. Los Angeles Archbishop Jose Gomez celebrated the Mass and blessed the Christmas lanterns, proudly made by Filipinos. And those are the stories making the headlines in the North American region. You can catch more of our news on our website, news.abs-cbn.com/tfcnews, on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel, and on the ABS-CBN News app on your smartphones and tablets. Back to our friends at The Rundown.